Time for baseball now on the show as we give you a look inside Guaranteed Rate Field in Chicago. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the San Diego Padres and the St. Louis Cardinals.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Major League Baseball on the show starts now.
Cardinals.
Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. He will lead this one off today. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. 65 degrees our temperature here at first pitch. And swung on and missed on a great pitch that time. And the leadoff man is down on strikes to get this one started.
Manny.
Fly ball right down the line and left. O'Neill waits on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Digging in next, Jake Cronenworth. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Lifted in the air to center field. Long run for the center fielder. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Ready now is Tommy Edman. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 misses off. Hit to third, taken in by Machado. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
That is second.
Now with the plate is Paul Goldschmidt. Down low, two balls and a strike. One out, nobody on. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Fouled off. The next 3-2. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down. And now Tyler O'Neill, head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. He's 0 for 5. Now the 2-1.
That's ball three.
Nolan Arenado would be next if they can keep this inning alive. The 3-1 pitch. Hot shot on the ground is short. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
That is cool. The third baseman, Nolan.
So now to the plate, Nolan Arenado. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Has a look, now the pitch. Two balls and two strikes now.
These are the great matchups that happen throughout the course of a game. I don't think as a pitcher you can give in right here. He's a great hitter at the plate. He knows it. You know it. Keep executing. Maybe get him to roll something over.
On the eighth pitch of the at bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Second inning set to go, and coming forward the veteran outfielder Will Myers. Here's the 3-1, and that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. Stepping up is Eric Hosmer. Myers on it. Nobody out. Now a throw over. Runner back safely. A ball and a strike to count to Hosmer. Hoping to discourage a steal attempt with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out.
That is good.
So now here is Victor Caratini looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. Here comes the 1-2. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Slow little grounder left side. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first. Two gone. In the hit will be Trent Grisham. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. And this one's in the dirt. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch. Here's the payoff pitch.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
A bouncer up the middle. Reined in. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. Head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. He's 0 for 7. The 1-1. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Now here's a swing and a ground ball for Frazier at second. And that's the first down. Up next, Dylan Carlson, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. Bottom of the second here with no score. Hit out towards second. He's got it. Throw gets him. Two down. So here is Edmundo Sosa trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Skied into straightaway right. And Tatis is there to end the inning. Set to get underway, and set to go is the second baseman, Adam Frazier. The 2-1 home is laid off up for ball number three.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and the Friars are into the hit column. At the plate now, Yu Darvish. And the pitcher is in fact bunting here as he puts this one down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection. One out now in the San Diego third, and that will bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. The 1-1 home. Frazier leads off second with one gone in the inning. 3-1. In the on deck circle is Manny Machado. He'll bat next. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings. Here's Manny Machado now. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. 1 and 2 now as that one's fouled off. From the belt, kicks and deals. The 1-2 is a breaking ball. They can't find the zone, and it's even at 2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Third inning, no score to this point. Hit in the air down the right field line, but this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Here's the pitch on 2-2.
Okay.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
This is on the ground over to first. There's one. On to the pitcher covering, and it's in time. A double play, and the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And into bat next, one of the fastest players in all of baseball, Harrison Bader. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Batting nine.
So in now is the Cardinals pitcher, Adam Wainwright. And he fouls this one off. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing our score. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. That brings in Tommy Edman, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. The 1-1 is in there for strike number two. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out this side in order. Jake Cronenworth as we begin the top of the fourth.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Hit to short, fielded cleanly. And the off-balance throw first, and that's a tough play. So here's Will Myers. All even now, 2-2. And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes, and the first two are retired here to begin inning number four.
The first base.
Next to hit, Eric Hosmer grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here, similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder giving chase. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And stepping in, the power hitting first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. just off the inside part of the plate. It's 3-1. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
Under it is Machado, and he'll take it for the first down. Next up, Tyler O'Neill. He singled first time up.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two now.
Nolan Arenado.
Now the 2-1 is a fastball in off the plate for a ball.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
Yeesh, not the kind of swing you're looking for. 3-1 as it runs to a full count now. 3-2. Count remains full. Here's the payoff pitch. Well struck down the right field line. But this will get five. So they'll do it again. 3-2. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Popped him up. Frazier is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Next to bat will be Victor Caratini. He'll be in there to start things out against Adam Wainwright. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Caratini is retired, and there's one away. Now at the plate, Trent Grisham. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. Next, here is Adam Frazier. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Center fielder on the run, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. Standing in now, Yu Darvish. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Scooped up on the second for the force out, and the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and now it'll be the catcher, Yadier Molina. And a slider gets away from him here as it just about got him in the ankle.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Fly ball out to straightaway right. And Tatis is there for out number one. Stepping in once again is Dylan Carlson. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Darvish pauses. Here's the 1-1. Down low, two balls and a strike. Got caught lunging there as this one's fouled away. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Another try at 2-2. That one doesn't even sniff the zone, missing very high. Looked like like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out. Next to dig in, Edmundo Sosa flew out in his only at bat so far. On the ground to third. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Sixth about to get started, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Fernando Tatis Jr. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And he makes first. Tatis is retired, and there's one away. So with one gone in the inning now, that brings in Manny Machado. A 1-1 home. Grounded weakly toward third. He's got it. Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away. So next to hit is Jake Cronenworth. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Hard hit ball to second. Reined in. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Into the box, Harrison Bader struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Pulled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Hit in the air to straightaway center. Grisham is under it to make the catch for out number one. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Adam Wainwright, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. 1-1. One ball and two strikes to count. And he won't go after the cut fastball. 2-2. And he'll try to hold back, but he won't be able to as that's ruled a swing, and there are two away now.
Now batter.
So two gone now in the St. Louis half of the sixth, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Softly hit toward the hole. Gonna be a tough play over the first, and that retires the side. Here's Will Myers. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. So one gone in the inning now, and that'll bring in the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Hard sinker misses 2-2. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
So far, this has been a terrific outing for this guy. Throwing well, keeping his pitches to a minimum, locating his fastball to both sides of the plate, good command of the off-speed pitches, very little traffic on the bases. So far, he couldn't have drawn up to be any better than he has been so far in this one.
And he struck him out. His eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one in.
Another pitch.
And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. He'll begin things here against Yu Darvish. The 1-2. High in the air down the right field line. And that will end up a foul ball. Now another 1-2.
Hey, this is a heck of a battle right here. Long AB. You know what? They find themselves still facing the starter. If they would have had some ABs like this earlier in the game, I think they get into the bullpen by this time.
Myers comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Next to hit now is Tyler O'Neill. He's 1-for-2 in
Tyler.
This one. To two balls and two strikes now. No runs, just one hit, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. Now a swing and a fly ball. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out. And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. Flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Into the box, Yadier Molina. Two balls and a strike to Molina.
Very impressive outing so far. His command has been spot on. Even when he misses his spot, it isn't out over the hard plate. He's throwing quality pitches.
And it's fouled away. Now a ball rolled softly to second. Scooped up. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Set for the start of the inning, and that brings up Trent Grisham. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two. Line to shortstop, and there's one away. So here's Adam Frazier. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. In there, a base hit. Cody Whitley enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Jurickson Profar will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 10, Jurickson Profar.
Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. The 1-1 is an off-speed pitch called for a strike. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Fastball is looked at for strike two. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And it's a foul ball. struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Austin Adams is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 54.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go. And set to go is the switch hitting outfielder, Dylan Carlson. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. To 2-2 now.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
And a swing and a miss there on a late-breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Fouled away. The next 1-2 pitch.
2-2.
One out, nobody on. Strikes him out as well. So two punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen.
Now
that will be Harrison Bader. He's 0-for-2 with a strikeout in this one.
Bader.
It's 1-2.
One ball.
And he lays off the pitch outside as they even at 2-2. Even at 2-2. The pitch. Right back to him on the mound. And they'll toss this one on to first as they're kept off the scoreboard again, and the inning is over. And in steps Manny Machado. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Oh, and look at this. High in the air and deep. And when this ball comes down, they'll have taken the lead. Home run. Andrew Miller will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Paul DeJong will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. Stepping in now, Jake Cronenworth. Two balls and a strike now. Hit well again down the right field line, and that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there.
Man, just a hair early on that one and just pulled it foul. It's going to have to find a way to refocus. Not easy to continue an AB after you just went deep foul.
Popped him up. Edmund is there for it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. So here's the cleanup hitter, Will Myers. Lifetime against Andrew Miller. He's 0-for-5. The 2-1 home. Short, hit hard. DeJong fields it cleanly. In time to first, and there are two away. Eric Hosmer to the plate now. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. The 3-1 pitch. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
I'm sure every pitcher on the staff could use an extra run right here. I know the bases are empty, and there's...
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Mark Melanson is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Paul DeJong. And this is taken for ball four. So just like that, the tying runs aboard to start the home half.
Second baseman,
and they'll play for the tie here as he puts this one down. throw is too late, so the sacrifice attempt turns into a base hit. At the plate, Paul Goldschmidt grounded back up the middle. Fielded cleanly to second for one. On to first, and Goldschmidt has bounced into a double play. Striding in is Tyler O'Neill, the potential tying run for him at third base. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. He's got it. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get it up on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single. To the plate now, Nolan Arenado. Popped him up. Caratini has a play. And no problem with that one as we are headed for extra innings. Digging in, the switch hitter, Victor Caratini. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot. Has to put the ball in play.
One and two now. Now the one and two pitch. He struck him out. The third time he's fanned in the game. Austin Nova will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder is on the run. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Batter will be Ha-Seong Kim. It's his job to get something into the outfield and give that go-ahead run a chance to score from second. Lays off the slider that time. 2-1. The other way to deep right field. Looking up is the right fielder, and they take the lead. It's gone. Jake Marisnik will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 16, Jake Marisnik.
Here's the 1-1. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Bader finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Daniel Hudson takes the ball, looking to make sure this game goes no further. Save situation here in inning number 10. Runner at second now. Nobody out. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Catch made in straightaway center as the runner tags from second. And as a result of that errant throw back in, he'll advance 90 feet here and move up from second to third. Big at bat now, and here is Dylan Carlson, though they might pitch around him here with a couple of bases empty. The 1-1. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Two pitches fouled away.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Here's another 2-2. Fouled off. Arenado takes his lead at third with one away. Grounded to the right. Scooped up. Throw on to first to be in time, but meanwhile the lead shrinks to one here on the RBI ground ball. Lars Nootbaar will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 58.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch. He ties him up with a fastball inside, 1-2. Well, as demonstrated there, that's a tough pitch to do anything with.
Yeah, good luck, but hey, a high fastball.
And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to complain as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2 the final finish. Mark Melanson is the winning pitcher of record. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ballgame. For the victorious San Diego Padres, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For St. Louis, 2 runs on 4 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. The winning pitcher is Mark Melanson. The loss goes to Andrew Miller. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 40 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.